Hello everyone and welcome to episode 18 of My Killing Love University Life. Formal introductions. The fear has dissipated, but the stress is still present. Once your oral presentation is over, head to the Custard Beer Cafe. Your relationship will be in the spotlight, but will it be accepted by the most important people in your life? A single replay that means we can do the root of Praia. Net. I stood back up and we're still didn't dare move. Wait. I was wondering when I would end up running into you. Is that the only thing you can come up with? She walked over to him and incredibly sure of herself shoved him up against the door. I thought that, how could you dare do that? She pinched him hard before letting her forehead drop against his chest. I'm sorry. Sorry? You didn't see my message or what? How could you leave without saying a thing? Nancy started pounding on her brother's shoulders, with all her strength. Ned seemed helpless. Between two pinches, he managed to grab her wrist and hold her still, before wrapping his arms around her. I'm alive. See? Calm down. They stood there a little while, one against the other, not moving. Well, he hugged his sister and then scanned the room until he made eye contact with me. Then he let go of Emma gently. How are you? How are you? You're asking me how I am? We definitely agree about that. You both have every right to be mad at me. I'm not mad. I'm happy and reserved to see you alive. I, on the other hand, am really and truly mad. Why didn't you answer my message? Where were you all the time? And what's with the new look? He sighed. I will make it short. I can't stay here long. What? You're leaving again? He paced around the room like a caged lion. He seems to be trying to get his thoughts. No, I'm not leaving again. And actually, I've already been back in town for a while. But so then why didn't you answer my messages? I couldn't. It is a deal I made with Eric. Eric? The cop. Thanks to him, I got to come back. I still don't understand the thing, Ned. You're going to have to be clearer. I told both of you I was in the touch with the cop. He's trying to break up the reign of dealers, and I'm helping him out by providing information. The night I got attacked, I was being tailed and we were getting close to our goal. When I got stabbed, our plan had fallen through. From then on, we knew I was going to be very closely watched. The only choice I had was to leave town. I couldn't risk contacting Eric, so I left, bright and early in the morning. Emma is handing on his every word. I can feel her and anxiety. I knew they had an eye on me. They hold on their head to the address to Amber's hotel and your room number, Melody. So I left without hesitating. I had to protect you from my dumb mistakes, from my selfish choices. But did you really plan on leaving for good? We made you change your mind. What made you change your mind? I was about to get to that. I drove away for that morning and I made my first stop about 300 miles from here to sleep. But smack in the middle of the night, a man knocked on the car window and woke me up. It was Eric. I don't know how, but the police have managed to locate me without getting directly in touch with me, since they were afraid the dealers would try to attack me again. Do you seriously think they would have killed you? In that case, why didn't they do it the first time around? Well, a mugging is much easier to pull off than a murder, especially if the victim is a police snitch. That's why Eric found me. He moved me to a hotel under police protection, and I stayed there several weeks. They destroyed my phone to make me untraceable, and from then on, I couldn't get any messages anymore. I'm sorry about that. You are still not answering the question why you are back. Isn't it too dangerous? The police must obviously expect you to still be in a safe place, but as usual, you just do as you. Me coming back is part of their plan, but... Why? To get their attention, I need to get myself noticed. without it being so obvious, so I'm playing along. I change my look to make them believe I think I'm incognito. I've been coming back to my apartment on a regular basis, mostly in the middle of the night, and I take streets that I have been watching until they come out of hiding. In a way, you're kind of bait. Exactly. But what are they making you take such big risks? Why don't they just arrest him right away? They don't have enough evidence. I have to confront them, to hash things out, and make them talk, to get them to face up to things. And Ned lifted his t-shirt to show up the clear wire running inconspicuously across his chest. And get everything recorded. I always have mics on me now, hooked straight up to the police. So you mean they are listening on this whole conversation now? Yes. And do you plan on getting them to confess before or after they stabbed you again? I realize they may seem careless, but it isn't. Nothing bad is going to happen to me. Okay, but please be careful. I will try. Anyway, I don't have a choice. People always have a choice in life, Ned. You're going to get yourself into trouble again. No, Amber, not this time. Cooperating with the police is the only solution if I want to put an end to this mess. I can't keep working with those crooks, and imagine I'm going to make it out unharmed. No, but you could just stop everything. Whatever the case is, I have to pay for my mistakes. But, in a way, helping the law take down the... I just clicked zonder reading it. but you... Ned walked across the room to take her in his arms. For once, I'm 100% sure I'm taking the right decision, trust me. Emma responded to her brother's hug right away, and hugged him harder, hanging onto his t-shirt. She hung onto as if she were going to lose him. Darn, my phone is in my bag. I rushed over to it to answer the call. It was casual. Hello? Yes, I just left my place. I'm on my way to meet up with you. Is everything okay? Kim and I have been trying to reach you for 10 minutes. We were worried sick. We agreed you were supposed to keep your phone on you. Wait, Ned is here. What? I heard him stop short. Nathaniel is with us. He is explaining what happened and I sum up the situation as briefly as I can. Damn, why do I get myself messed up in this? Well, anyway, whatever. I'm going home. I'll let you all talk. Keep me posted. Oh, okay. He hung up and I put my phone away. Casual? Yes, we were on a commando mission to try to find you. I was planning on meeting up with you in the city you went to and... And what city might it be? You could have waited so much time. I was just... You have no idea what I went through. I was all upset. I would have moved heaven and earth to find you. I didn't dare call the police for fear of it causing you even more trouble. I was lost. Okay, sorry. Have you been back for weeks? Why didn't you come to see us sooner? I wanted to, but Eric was postponing it as much as possible. He was afraid I endanger you in addition to getting myself noticed. For now, I just have to make it look like I'm back to pick up my stuff before moving on to the phase B of the plan. Phase B? And who is investigating this plan? Yes, the phase when I have to go see them and beg them to let me back in on their plans, pretending to be down and out and lost without them. It's the police ID. That's too risky. Right the second he put his glasses on, and I thought I noticed a smile on his face. I get the impression the situation excites him more than it worries him. I'm sorry, I have to go. Don't try to find me for the next few days, and don't come here anymore. You left us the key to your apartment. I did, and it was a stupid move. He walked around the room, picking up a few things. Emma grabbed his wrist to stop him. You aren't in one of your favorite detective novels. You only have one life, Ned. Precisely, and I'm trying to do something right this time. I have to go. Emma glanced at him, panicked. She watched her brother by himself, busy himself rummaging around his room, in search of his stuff. So you are leaving again? So I'm doing what I have to. I'm doing what's best. He put his hands on the doorknob. I would have preferred not running into you too. I didn't want to upset you now. I know that you are in the middle of your final weeks. Don't worry. This mess will be settled soon. I will come meet up with you afterwards. He finished through the doorway, and we heard him rush down the stairs. Right afterwards. After what? Let's go. I stood there a few seconds frozen smack in the middle of the room before coming back to my senses. Amber, you okay? Let's go, Betty. I don't even want to talk about it anymore. She picked up her stuff and I followed her. Amber headed out of the park at the fast pass. You going back to the hotel? Yes. Okay, you want me to come with you? No, you should go home too. In any case, the jerk isn't even aware of all the hurt he has caused. I'm not aware of the state of disappear he left me in. I mean, for him, it's just a game, as usual. You all need to get some rest and take a step back from everything that's going on now. I think, and besides, the police are on his side. Nothing will happen to him. We will see, but the last time the police is his back, whatever. Sorry, thanks for tonight in any case. And if you run into Kim and Cashel, thank them for me too. But right now, I just need to go home. Yeah, I get it. Suddenly, she did an about face and headed out of the park in a hurry. I was waiting for you in the park. Geez, you scared the bejibbers out of me. You okay? Yes, but I get the feeling this whole mess is a little beyond me. And in any case, there isn't much I can do, so I'm going home. I'll walk you home. And he did just as he said, and walked me all the way to campus gates. We didn't talk much on the way. I needed to think about everything that had just happened. Before going our separate ways, we wished each other good luck for the last minute study and the oral presentation. I went home to bed exhausted. I have a big day ahead tomorrow. I have to remember my current concern is to pass my oral, and the stakes are really high. Annette and I really don't have the same priorities. And other than being there for him and a good listener, I don't see how I can get him over this spiral. He's the only one who can take that initiative. I forced my eyelids shut and struggled to get to sleep, but it was in vain. My eyes were wide open when the sun rose and my alarm clock ran. I got up around 7 a.m. at the same time as Eileen. She plunged into her notes immediately with her headphones on. I heard her whispering her oral presentation non-stop to memorize it. She seems really concentrated. So am I. I have to stay focused on my calls. I finish gathering up all of my stuff, go and meet up with Alexi right away. I promised him we practice our oral presentation together this morning. I made sure to take everything I needed and I left the room. He isn't here yet. Still, I'm about 15 minutes early. Weird, I didn't sleep last night. I should feel tired, but I don't. Last night ended in a pretty strange way. No way I could sleep after everything that happened. I had images of Ned and what he said running through my head non-stop. The situation seemed like it came straight out of a spy movie. Hi. Hey. I didn't even see you. I was lost in thoughts. No pop. Alexi will be here soon. Oh, I didn't realize you were practicing with us. Practicing? Personally, I found we were going away for a weekend at the beach, with cocktails and clubbing on the agenda. What? No. The oral presentations are next week. I absolutely have to get ready. And you believe him? I have to get ready for my oral too. I like partying, but we are not reckless, Melody. For a second there, I panicked just a little. She knows you well. It was pretty plausible. I know how to be serious. Prove it to me. Morgan took the head to heading towards the campus gates. Where are we going? Oh, I didn't tell you, sorry. We are going to Rosa. She needs to study too. And I figure it wouldn't be a bad idea to do it in a small group to give each other feedback on what we prepared. Plus that we will give us practice just the oral in front of the jury, since apparently there are supposed to be 3 people on it. Yeah, that's right. Good idea. Let's go. Meet up with Morgan. We met up with Morgan, who was already outside, and we set out towards Rosalia's apartment. I pressed on Rosa's intercom bell. Hi, thanks for having us over. You're kidding, thank you for helping me out on my oral presentation. We went and sat down on the couch, as usual. A bunch of little muffins and cookies awaited us on the coffee table. Rosie, you went a lot of trouble again, even though you swore you wouldn't. It's the sugar. It gives me energy and it helps me concentrate. I couldn't help it. Thanks, that's really sweet. Actually, I figured you would, and we wanted to pitch in this time, so we didn't come empty-handed. Lexi put out the take-out box of egg rolls and samosas. This is for lunch. Wow, thanks, guys. It smells incredibly good. I'm going to put it in the fridge. Here I am, in the middle of all this, and I didn't bring anything. I thought we were going to study at the library. Sorry. You pissed in by always worrying about us. You show up as soon as we needed help or advice, so let us take care of you for once. He's right. I feel bad about it. I will stuff myself with egg rolls and spring rolls, just to make you feel happy. Yeah, right. With all the commotion, we had trouble getting settled and calming down to study, but we finally managed to. Who wants to go first? I do. I will take the plunge before getting totally discouraged. She got up and stood facing us. She turned her computer towards us so we could follow her slideshow. She kept filling in with the tip of her blouse. She seems nervous. Come on, get into the right frame of mind. Imagine we are the jury ready to listen to you. Mostly you took a deep breath before getting started. Okay, hello. So first I'm going to present the outline of my presentation. It's a way to sum up the progress of my analyse. She forgot to introduce the topic. So, to start, Rosalie is having trouble making her presentation. She keeps coming back to certain slides to give us information she forgot the first time around. I get the feeling the stress has totally overwhelmed her. The allotted speaking time is 20 minutes, but right now, Rosalie has already been struggling for 30 minutes, and we were only halfway through her analysis. None of us interrupted her, but I still made eye contact with Alexi, who seemed to share the same concern. I think I'm finished. Sorry, I got the technical side at one point. The pedalogies of the 20th century most famous serial killer is a topic that's easier to understand for people who are used to physiological jargon. I hope I didn't lose you along the way. No, don't worry about it. So what do you all think? Well, it was, how should I put it? Okay, I don't want to answer this answer, but I want to know what the solution is, what happens when you say it for the episode account, so I'm gonna do it. It was really not bad, Rosa. I'm sure you're going to ace it like that the day of your presentation. Really? Thanks, that's reassuring. I was so stressed out. I must be the one misrepresenting really once again. Thanks for your ability. We are here to help her. But I'm sure she's going to manage on the big day. It will be okay. Okay, that did go down with Alexi. That is what I didn't expect it. Sure, but she needs constructive encouragement that will push her in the right direction. What's that supposed to mean? I think it was a little muddled. You know your subject, but you let yourself get flustered by the stress. Alexi is right. You went back over what you said pretty often, and the transition from the parts about your analysis didn't follow very well. Oh, I see. Thanks for your honesty. It's just that it's been a long time since I last spoke in public. I will try to let you take your turns, and I'll try again afterwards. Yeah, it's just a matter of practice. That's why we were here. Just that I'm afraid of not being legit. I missed a lot of classes, so. But you worked hard, and you know your subject. Alexi took Rosalie's hand in his. You're going to manage. It's the home stretch, and we were here to support you. And of course, you let it off for your presentation. It's your topic, the one you choose. And I'm sure we'll be waiting for you next week to hear you talk about it. You can't even be here to steer you there to cheer you on if you want us to. Meaning, you know, it's a Mr. presentation in a public event. Anyone can attend. But if you think that might flatter you, we won't come. It's up to you to tell us. True, that detail had totally slipped my mind. Rosa sat down next to me with a sigh. Come on, my turn. Morgan got up and stood facing us. So I have already rehearsed this a bunch of times with you, since we are doing the same major. But it won't do me any harm to rehearse it one more time. Come on, hurry up. There are people who need to practice much more than you. Don't start. Come on, go. Well, I for one am going to discuss the role of influencers in the digital market today. Cool subject, very contemporary. You know, you are putting pressure on us more than anything else. You're doing it again. Well, I have to do a few things to make it a little harder on you. What's going on? Nothing. Morgan sat back down on the couch with a frown on his face. You are incapable of acting serious, not even for one single afternoon. This is the fifth time I've listened to you, and you are perfect. You don't hesitate a single time. Your speech is organized and flows. I will even be surprised if you don't get the highest possible grade. But if you rehearse too much, you could end up having the opposite effect. That'd be a real shame. So in that case, why did you came? Why did I came? To help us from a dream jury. You have to understand, I haven't been able to rehearse my presentation a single time since the two of us talked about it. I know you have to have everyone's approval to be reserved, but you should let the ones who are really having trouble make their turns. The two guys are both on the defensive, digging in their heels. Each one is in a corner, arms crossed and avoiding eye contact. How about we go make some... I think I already answered it. I did it yesterday. But it was wrong in my notes that I have lying here. B. Do you mind settling your difference once and for all? So we can move on. She replied, and be more practical if we started by one who really needed it. But I really need practice. Rosalie grabbed me inconspicuously by the wrist. Come on, I'm going to squeeze us some fresh juice. I followed her into the kitchen. You don't take me necessary. You are the top student in the graduation class. I practically haven't seen you in the past few weeks because you have spent all your time studying. Being the best student has a prize, Alexei. You don't take my studies seriously either. Because you think you've got to be kidding. Things are bound to blow up. Wait, what's going on? Alexei told me there have been a few tensions between them lately. And there I was thinking there wasn't a cloud in paradise. A paradise has been holding its own for about 10 months now. I hadn't realized they already been together so long. Yeah, and they share everything. Night out, weekend days, they came and confided in me not long ago, one after the other. I think they both have things to say to each other, but neither one is taking the initiative to do it. Still I'm wondering it would end up blowing in their face. I glance over at the guys. They still seem mad but are talking to each other in a whisper now. You think it's going to be okay? Time will tell. I gave Rosa hand setting four glasses down on a tray. Wilson squeezed oranges and lemon in a pitcher, and after that we went back and sat down with the guys. It's because I'm stressed out and we're still waiting for the answer from the company you contacted in Washington. You know perfectly well it was just to try and see. So you're still now, still you know they are going to hire you. Your application is excellent. They'd be stupid to depress themselves of someone as outstanding as you. Morgan ran his finger gently over Alexei's lips. I'm sorry. I don't know. As if I were stealing for time. I don't want us to get to the end of this year. I put the tray on the table silently, as not to interrupt them. I love you. What? I love you, and geez, it is a relief to tell you. I was afraid of saying it until now. By holding back, I was keeping us from going to the end of the year, or from splitting me up. Morgan hugged Alexei and kissed him. I love you too. I couldn't leave you. I will go to Washington only if you will come with me. Alexei, Rosalie and I exchanged a little smirk. I held back a giggle. I hate to ruin this emotionally intense moment. I tried to stay focused on the glasses in front of me. But maybe we should talk about this some other time. Yeah, maybe. Sorry, it's hard resisting your face. He took Morgan's cheeks in his hands and put his face closer to Morgan to kiss him. Alright, come on. Your turn, Melody. Okay. I stood up, self-confident, but once I was facing my three friends, I realized it was more complicated than I meant. I felt the stress in front of my brothers. What was going to be like in front of the jury? Okay, phew, so... breathe, there's time. I took a deep breath and went for it, even though I stammered several times. And I blew a blank of certain days, or ran into technical trouble with my sides. Apparently, I didn't do all the bad. The topic of your presentation is awesome. I should have studied art history. Yeah, it's in the news. I wasn't expecting that. And your conclusion is inspiring, committing and hopeful for female shows in the future. For sure, I found the positive vision of the future really exhilarating. It's a change from what we usually read about on the topic. Oh, thanks. I wasn't expecting so much positive feedback. You earned it, really. Thanks. We talked briefly about some specific points before taking a break for lunch. Then it was Marcus' turn. And he was definitely perfect. He impressed himself with impulsive clarity. And even managed to capture our attention on an initiatively fairly inspired subject. Then it was Alexei's turn. Strangely enough, his students seemed to lack self-confidence. After which we all worked on a presentation based on our feedback we had given each other. And Alexei rose at practice oral second time. They had already improved substantiously. So it's pretty wild to require us to do an oral presentation when we haven't even been trained to do one. It's only 40 minutes of our lives, and they do need a way to evaluate us. And yet, right now, we are just practicing for our presentation. It's a Q&A part, it's the whole different ballgame. We will do fine, I'm not worried about this. Anyway, let's go, it's getting late. It's better if we go get some rest, so we'll be able in shape for what lies ahead. We chatted as we collected our stuff. Are you doing okay these days, Melody? You look exhausted. Oh, I haven't really recovered from last night. Was there a party I didn't hear about? You should be in event planning, not socializing. I'm sure I can combine the two. I will find a way. No, not really a party. An evening with Amber to find that. Oh, I ran into her last week and she looked devastated. I guess it wasn't easy. We found him. They all stopped short. What do you mean? And you waited all day before telling us that? Actually, he'd been back for several weeks. Morgan and Alexei sat down on the couch and Rose looked at me, standing in shock. I started telling the story about the thing that I had gone wrong last night. They asked me a bunch of questions, but unfortunately, I didn't have even half of the answers. I explained that the thing was cooperative with the police, but I told them to keep the details to themselves. No one was supposed to know. It's complicated. They're going to make a move within the next few days, and I have no way of knowing what is happening. This whole mess is totally wild and dangerous, for sure. I'm worried about you. You're much too involved in this mess. The story of psychopath leaders who are capable of stabbing people in the street are beyond us. I didn't dare say so. You definitely know that Ned and I grew apart after high school, and I don't want you to imagine that I choose him based on his best acts, but Morgan is right. You should take a step back, especially in right now. You're doing your oral presentation. It may seem insignificant compared to Nathaniel's problems, but you are preparing your future. You know you are always been there for us and for everyone else, but focus on yourself this time. Right, I hear your precious advice. I'm not forgetting myself. We're here for you if ever a situation like this comes up again. Thanks. We finished trading up the apartment, and I hugged Rosalia before leaving in Alexi and Morgan's company. Come on, let's get to bed. Our heads are full and our eyelids heavy. The time has come. A bit dramatic. Alexi goes to sleep walking like a monarch. Anyway, his head high and chest puffed out. What a theoretical exit. Maybe I should have gone after a career in acting. Or not. I can't believe that I'm working through this gate for one of the last times in my life. That's actually what I was thinking a few days ago, the end of our student years. You are close to make me nostalgic ahead of time. Good night to you too, and thanks for today. I really feel ready for my presentation now. It was a great idea. That for sure. You have good ideas often, Alexi. Like the one that consisted of kissing you, you mean? Morgan kissed Alexi on the cheek, laughing. For example, yes. Good night, you two. Tell Yuna said hello. He is at his family for the weekend. Okay. Alexi helped me to wish me a good night, and I went to take the elevator. Hey, hi, how's it going? I spent my day getting ready for the oral, and I can't wait for the big day to be here. Can't wait. Yes, since after I finish with my studies, I'll finally be able to do what I want. So you're going to go to the Tate to be a guide? Yes, and your mother? It's still convincing that I'm going to change my mind at the last minute and that I won't do it, which makes me want to go my own way even more. I see. It's my future after all. True. I put my stuff down next to my desk as I yawned. You look exhausted. I'm going to go to bed. I studied hard enough for today. Okay, good night. I don't even have the energy to take a shower. I will do that tomorrow. For once, I fell asleep the very second my head hit the pillow. Sunday was tedious. I sat in bed in comfortable clothes to work on a certain aspect of my presentation again. Melody and Charlie also came to pay us a visit, and together we finalized our feedback on their modern art project. I didn't fear much from the others. Everyone seems to be concentrated on studying. I wrote to Emma like me. She hasn't had heard from Nathaniel. I went to bed pretty early. I didn't fall asleep right away, but I need to be in good shape for the weekend ahead. Go on, here goes the last week of class. For the rest of our lives. Whoa, said that way, it sounds pretty weird. I'm super excited about it. Ending. Besides, I've already started looking for places to live in London. I can't wait to get there. London must be a pretty nice place to live. You are kidding? The party capital with its atypical architecture ranges from hyper modern to so British. Oh, I can't wait. It really seems to you have found your calling. Just goes to show childhood dreams change. She walked out the door, whistling cheerfully. It's definitely the first time I've seen her like that. It took me a while, a whole school year, to see Eileen acting positive. When I think back to the first of the year and my state of shock, when I found that she was my roommate, I think we were both wrong about each other. So you coming? Because becoming a doorwoman isn't my career plan, by the way. Hurry up. All right, I was lost in thought. For sure, I'm still not used to that aspect of your personality. People have to be pretty patient to put up with it. I stared at her and smiled. Wait, you criticize and criticize, but deep down, I know you're going to miss me when you are in London. Wait, aren't you answering back? I've run out of arguments. Maybe because deep down you aren't wrong. I couldn't help smiling. I mean, except when you make that face there. I don't know how I managed to stand it all year. You're impossible. That's what makes me charming. Yelena locked the door behind us and we headed for the first class of the day. Hi, I sat down next to Chani towards the front of the auditorium, and Lilien went a little farther down. This is our last class with Mr. Zadie. Yeah, I felt like I'm saying farewell to all my little routines here. It's weird. I see what you mean exactly. Good morning, I hope you are all well. We are going to start by making the rounds for your feedback, and we'll see about the rest afterwards. He came in the door and sat down at his desk. It doesn't have his back today. Our feedback sucks. I hadn't even noticed Melody was sitting behind us. It doesn't suck, it's what we went through. We are not supposed to judge, it's just that state the facts. It's because my photographs were horrible. I thought they had some potential, but it was dead wrong. The first group on the other side of the auditorium answered questions. You have to admit, Yelena's mother didn't help. I would have heard better if we didn't have the problem. I get the impression most of you love doing this exercise. The aim is for it to be useful to you in your career, and I'd like to see you all got so involved in the project. The groups all spoke one after another, sharing their project's latest ups and downs. When it was our turn, Yelena stood up without giving us the time to say anything whatsoever. She summed up the twists and turns clearly. I got the feeling she had prepared her speech. And to conclude, there was one last twist. This very morning, a cafe in the area agreed to put Melody's photograph on the show all summer long. Chani and Melody looked up in surprise. A cafe? Yes, I didn't mention it to you because I was slightly mindful already. I got it at the last minute, but what could be better than a cafe? People come there ever to sit, and they have time to contemplate the works of art on show. It's a great idea, Yelena. We usually only think of contacting establishments capable of judging our work. But we also need to consider places where people are just passing through. I don't know what to say. Thanks, Yelena. It's normal. It's our project. Yeah, but it matters more to me than I would have thought. I'm the one in the pictures. I know. There was a moment of hesitation in the auditorium. I thought the two of them were going to walk towards each other and hug. There was so much emotion. But Mr. Zadie took the floor and went on questioning the other groups. Did Yelena tell you ahead of time that she was going to do that? No, but she said that it just happened this morning, and I don't think she's the type of giving up. She needs a victory, even a small one. You're right, that really sounds like her. Anyway, thanks for your feedback and your involvement in this project. It's really a very nice way to end the year. I couldn't bring this moment with you to the close without offering you one last class a little offbeat. I think you're going to know me as far as that goes, so no need to get out your pens, notebooks and whatnot. Let's get out and get some fresh air. We should be used to this kind of thing with him, but despite everyone seems surprised. Come on, don't make such a face. Take your things and follow me. You won't ever be coming back here anyway. I wonder what he has planned this time. Come on, let's go off campus. We have already spent too much time here. I mean, for several of you, more than me, considering it's just my first year at Enros. Are you taking us to have a drink, sir? No, I play something much more useful than a drink. You will see. We're going to sit down here. It's perfect. Perfect for what? Are we going to hunt for graffiti again? A hunt for graffiti? Is that all you do in this class? I hope they have learned much more from me, but it looks like this is what left the biggest impression on them. What have they got planned? Thank you, Mr. Director, for here joining us for this very special class. You have all my support, Ryan. You know that. So we know perfectly well what an oral presentation can cause in terms of stress. That's why I like to suggest a few techniques that could possibly help you control it. Same of these techniques resemble so ferociously. Excellent. Thanks for being so enthusiastic, Chani. We are going to start with some simple little things. I'm going to show you different acupressure points to help you manage the tension and try to calm it down. The director also shared different ways of regulating on breathing and when speaking. And we were also entitled a few exercises, one after another. We finished up with a relaxing session, all lying down in the park. The least you can say is that it was definitely offbeat. We had several fits of laughter during the class, especially when the director showed. Mr. Zadie had to breathe correctly by placing his hand and gently on Mr. Zadie's stomach. It was a good way to relax before tackling the crazy week ahead of us. So voila, it's over. I wish you a successful presentation, even though I'm not worried about you. I love working with you and I hope not to see you again next year. In any case, not here on campus. I look forward to running into you in your future places of employment or elsewhere. After his speech, he thanked us and we said goodbye. Then the whole class started applauding, much to his surprise. A group of girls who I had never spoken to even came up and brought him flowers, rewarding him with the best teacher in the universe. Thanks, I'm really touched, but I couldn't be the best teacher without the outstanding students I had this year. I hope you thought to get me a bouquet too. I'm kidding, don't worry. After all these years, I'm used to handing out awards than receiving them. And what better time to announce that Mr. Zadie will be staying with us next year as a tenured professor of contemporary modern art history. Really? I didn't think the government was planning on giving enough subsidy to. I had to bend my fist on the table, obviously, but there was no way we were going to let a professor so devoted to his students leave. Yes, congratulations, you deserve it. Thank you. I took part in the applause with pleasure. Some students stayed to talk with the director and others headed back to campus. How about we cut a coffee? I'm not very hungry. Guess my stomach is in knots. With the upcoming presentation. I understand. Maybe we'll eat later in the afternoon. Wanna go to the Costa Beer Cafe or does that bother you? No, just the opposite. Your suggestion comes at a good time. I need to see Clemens anyway. About resigning. Okay, let's go. Hello, wait. Are you working today? I must have made a mistake. No, I was just in the neighborhood, and I wanted to talk to you about resigning. And you already introduced me to your replacement? Who? Me? No way. I mean, that's nice of you to offer. I'm just here for a cup of coffee. Welcome. So, go have a seat outside. I will be right out. Thanks. Chani went out, leaving us both alone. So, what do you want to talk about? Well, when can we wrap things up and... Well, we have time. Besides, maybe you will still be working here next year. You haven't passed all your classes yet, as far as I know. No, right, but I still hope I have a good chance of... And you know what they say. Don't count your chickens before they hatch. Right, I get it, but... Besides, if worse comes to worse, if I manage to leave the cafe, you can take over. There is always be a job for you in the bargain. I know that in art, there aren't a lot of openings. So, this is a great opportunity I'm offering you, don't you think? It is not exactly what I had in mind. And besides, I'm waiting to hear back from several companies I applied to for internships. You are kidding. An internship doesn't pay. So, hand on to your apron. You will see. Besides, if you want to resign, you can just leave the key in the mailbox and send me a text. I will email you all the paperwork. Oh, what there was more red tape for? You know what I think of red tape. We can just as easily sit down and handle it together, can't we? So that's all there is to say, is to it. You say when, and that very day you can resign, no problem. Oh, okay. Hi. Oh, hi, Yun. I don't know you were working a shift today. Yeah, it wasn't planned, but I needed money for my vacation. Where are you going? Right now, I'm still undecided, but I'd like to go to Australia. Seriously? Awesome. It's still just an idea, but yeah. It's good you are here. I wanted to ask Clemens to let us throw a party at the cafe. A party? For free? We have people pay for drinks, of course, but that'd be a private event. What's the occasion? For graduation, of course. We want that off some steam. After the awards, don't you think? Yes, sure, but when did you plan on having it? After the graduation ceremony? No, just after our awards. We won't have our grades yet. We can't party without worrying about our future for a change. Besides, we are not all sure to be around next year. So this weekend? Yeah, why not, yes. My parents are supposed to be going. Oh, bummer, I won't be anywhere near as fun if you aren't there. But I'm sure you will have a good time, even without me. Other than that, it would be nice if you waited for my green light, eh? Yes, of course, Clemens. So, well, I agree. I trust you. Yun, I mean, I trust you both. Oh, thank you, Clemens. But only if you're both here to make sure that it all goes well. If you are alone here, Yun, you won't be able to handle everything. We all know perfectly well how the kind of party can get out of hand. Oh, too bad, don't worry. You don't see your family often, and you really should take advantage of those. Wait, just the opposite, I could invite them. Yeah, sure, if you wanted to, why not after all? I'm suggesting that because lately they've been insisting on meeting my friends, and I figured why not kill two birds with one stone? Good idea. Well, I have to make sure it suits him. And I think about it, and think about it a little. Anyway, your friend is waiting. I'm going to serve her coffee, but you take over afterwards. Got it. Clemens left us alone inside. Seems like she is softening up as time goes by. Yeah, I'm going to have to get used to it. I have trouble believing it. Even though with you, she's always been sweet. Let's not get back on that topic. Okay, in any case, for the party, I don't know if... take the time to check with them and tell me if you are available for the party or not. Okay, let's do it that way. Anyway, I have to meet up with Chani outside. She's been alone with Clemens much too long. Good luck this week. Thanks. Good luck to you too. I walked out the cafe. Thanks, I'm going to take a little right away. Plus, I already got what I needed. Yeah, as an easy as this can be. Sorry to have keep you waiting, Chai. I was talking to... to you, yeah. Clemens told me. No prop. And turns out I've already finished my coffee. We can just go buy sandwiches at the cafeteria. How about it? Good idea. How much do I owe you for your coffee, Clem? It's on the house. It's in the exchange for your precious favor. Oh, thanks. Are you sure I... I insist. Have a good day, girls. And good luck this week. Thanks. Clemens bumped into me like little as she walked back inside the cafe, then stopped beside me in louder voice. That young lady is extraordinary. She is already back inside the cafe before I had time to answer. Hey, you coming? Chani swung her back over her shoulder and headed towards campus. What kind of spell did you put on her? None. She said you were awesome. What was she talking about? I just gave her some little rituals to bring prosperity to her business. What? How did you manage to get on the subject of whiskers in barely 2 minutes? That's wild, and Clemens never say coffee is on the house. She just noticed the talisman on my back. She seems to know about Wicca. She's the one who brought the subject up, not me. Seriously, that's wild. Looks like there are far more riches in the world than I thought. We survived the witch hunt. Long ago. Now we are back more powerful and more numerous than ever. You are scary. And I love that. So what did the ritual consist of? She walked into the cafeteria without answering me. Wait for me. A little salt moonlight water and a chrysoprase stone, that's all. Right, things everybody has around the house, of course. All she has to do is leave a gallic of water under the light of the full moon to create moonlight water, and Clemens said the rest. How do you know all these things? It's incredibly curiosity. When someone gets me started on a topic, I don't know how to stop. I should be used to it, but you keep surprising me. Come on, let's grab some sandwiches and get out of here. Okay, I'm right behind you. We sat down on a bench to eat our sandwiches, then we went on Mr. Labar's class. At the end of the last 4 hours, the metaphor and art history of life were entailed to a warm farewell. I walked across the campus class towards my room. As for Chani, she had a few errands to run. I'm doing my oral presentation Friday. There are my last few days to go back over things. We still have a few classes left, but they are optional. I can't really decide if I'm ready or not, but I have no choice. I have to be. I can't mess up. I headed to my room. At this moment, you can find the fairy. If you go now to the library and switch between this place and the library, she will pop up in the library. I already did that on the route with Hyun, so if you want to see it, just look in the description box down below for a link to the video. You will get a cape, by the way. One speck in my wound, I read through the notes for my oral again. I practically know them by heart. That's not necessarily a good idea though. The oral is a give and take exercise. It has to be spontaneous and not give the impression I'm reacting the text. I can't wait for this all to be over. I feel like I've reached my limit of theoretical learning. I need to let off some steam. For that matter, I need to give a union answer, so we have time to organize our party at least a little. What should I do? My parents already be here, and they want to meet my friends. After all, it is the perfect opportunity. Even though Priya will be there, I could always introduce her as a friend, but I'm sick of hearing the news the word boyfriend. Admitting the truth to them would limit the kind of uncomfortableness. The best thing would be to talk to him about it. I dialed my mother's number that I know by heart, obviously. Hello, Mom, it's me. Hey, I'm calling you because if you don't feel like it, I can easily cancel, seeing as how nothing is ready yet. You haven't told me what you were talking about. Well, we might organize a party Friday after our orals. Oh, would you rather we come Saturday so we won't bother you? No, just the opposite. All my friends will be there. And I was thinking that it was a good opportunity to introduce them to you, since you've been insisting on it quite a bit lately, and... That's a great idea. But you are such sure we won't bother you? It's not a party for parents. We wouldn't want to. I'm not ashamed of you. Besides, I've got a kind of second family here, and it's important for you to meet them. Oh, we're already looking forward to meet them. Thanks for the invitation. Philip, we are going out on Friday night. Out on the town, like the old days. Ooh la la, I'm going to have to rehearse my dance steps. It's still the golden age of disco, isn't it? Geez, you're going to make me regret this. Quit this and help before you withdraw your invitation. Stay focused, we are behind you. We love you. You're going to ace it. Ha, thanks, I love you too. Good night, sleep tight. And don't overdo the reviewing. I'm sure you are going to manage. Thank you both, good night. I hung up and talked to you right away. It's weird organizing a party that will be held after our exams. I'm looking forward to it too much. It feels like it's an entire anyway. And yet, it's just Friday night. I went to take a shower and put on my pajamas. When I picked my phone up again, I realized that Yoon had already sent out the invitations for the party. He also asked me to contact Amber to invite her. Okay, Amber. And the last two times I invited her, so I'm not gonna invite her now. See if it changes. If you invite her, she goes up, by the way. It isn't a good idea. She's going to think that I'm taking what happened lightly and she is likely to take it wrong. I told Hyun that I didn't feel like doing it. Considering everything that happened recently with her brother, I feel like it is inappropriate. We still don't know if the police have made a move the way Ned said they would. Maybe they are all in prison, including him, and we have no idea. Come to think of it, it would generate a buzz after all. It's a small town, and Priya keeps a close eye on what is happening in the court system here. Maybe he should have heard. And let's out the sign hopes of chasing away all the questions, Johnny away at me. Maybe I'm going to follow my mother's advice, stop studying, and go to sleep after all. I still have all the day tomorrow to get ready. I'm gonna look back at Amber if it changed. No, it didn't change at all. And you didn't go down either. So that is just an slash. Okay. I sat down to watch the series. It's been a while. I managed to fall asleep a little later on. The stress must be getting to me despite everything. I started to feel the lack of sleep echoing me over the past few nights. Hey, I got home last night, and I didn't know if you were sleeping, but your laptop was on, sitting next to you. I was half asleep, watching the latest episode of Black Mirror. The latest season is out. I have to see it. Yes. So this is home stress before the orals. Are you going to spend your day studying here? Yes, that's definitely what I was thinking about doing. Same for me. So good luck then. Thanks, good luck to you too. The afternoon continued in the same studious way. It was until the early evening that my review in got through, off by an unsettled message. Hey girls, I'm writing both of you because we promised to if anything new came up in the investigation, and it's Nina. I was in town with my mom when we saw several police cars in parking in an alley. Obviously, that attracted the attention of everyone walking around the area, including us. It's him, I'm sure of it. It's the guy who attacked me. He got arrested. Him and several other people were dragged off by the cops. I swallowed hard and read it several times to make sure I really understood what she was saying. Don't you think that just finally ended up investigating deeper after closing my case without further action? You said it would end up paying off. You were right. Obviously, Nina doesn't know how many cases this guy is messed up in. I wish to complain Nina felt had been enough to look him up. I got up to open the door. I already knew who it was. Did you get the message? Yes, just now. So how are you? I'm not totally relieved. Briar held me in her arms as she leaned, who had put her pyjamas back on, looked only in surprise. It's normal that you aren't. Briar glanced over at Yelena, who seemed to be trying to understand the situation in vain. Come here, let's go talk outside. Are you going to be okay? Yes, maybe you should try to contact Amber to tell her. You think so? Yes, not telling her would be a bad idea, trust me, as far as that goes. But we don't really know what's going on. I'm at least going to tell her as much as I know. I dialed Amber's number to no avail. I just ran and ran, and I got her voicemail. On the third try, I left a message telling her what I knew, meaning as a whole, nothing about Ned other than the group of leaders being arrested. Come on, let's sit down a second. I let myself be dragged over to a bench. She wrapped her arms around my shoulders in a comforting move. I'm going to answer Nina first and tell her we are available if she needs to talk. I can't believe that happened right in the middle of downtown. It's most likely be in the news tomorrow. I'm not surprised they were hiding out in town. The police always wants to avoid making a scene, and they are too many risk for hurting citizens who had nothing to do with it. To tell the truth, it's the best hideout for a bunch of dealers. I hadn't thought of that. Why did it take so long to arrest them, if those guys ran right under our noses? Unfortunately, I can't answer your questions. But getting a warrant to interfere it in a public place, which potentially implies endangering civilians, takes time. They were most likely waiting to gather more evidence. It always takes forever, and at least times for other people to get attacked or stabbed. I know, and your anger is legitimate. I hope Ned is okay. I hope so too. In any case, he did everything in his power to save his skin and help the authorities. They're sure to lessen his sentence. But does that mean there will necessarily be a sentence? Given the charge against him, I prefer not trying to you, but yes, there will be. I was totally refusing to admit it, but deep down, I figured Ned was facing a heavy sentence. Even by helping the police, he'd been involved in a mess for way too long to let be totally off the hook. You think he's going to do prison time? I don't know, there's a possibility, but he might also get through it without. I don't know all the ins and outs of the case. True. I know it is frustrating and that you're worrying enough for the whole world. But the orals are tomorrow. Tomorrow. You have to stay focused. I know. I'm not going to screw everything up now. Don't worry about me. Of course I'm worried about you. You mean a lot to me, and you spend your time watching over others. Let me watch over you for once. You can't go into such an important moment in your life because of other people's choices. No matter how kind and loving you are to them, if you don't take care of them, you won't be able to take care of others. I was surprised by Papaya's silver tone. That's what makes our relationship so special. I will always be frank with you. I kissed her gently to conclude our conversation. Go on, we both need a good night to sleep. Yes. Good night. Oh, by the way, did you get the invitation for the party unit organizing. Oh yes, that's really a good idea. I can't wait to be here. Our parents will be there too. What? I prefer telling you ahead of time. Okay, and couldn't you have waited until after the orders to keep me from having heart failure? Oops, sorry. I kissed her, smiling. Otherwise, if I try to rationalize, it's cool they will be here. And no pressure, you will see how you feel about it when the time comes. No pressure, right? And we kissed one last time, regretting not being able to sleep together, but that wouldn't have been serious. Brian made one last joke about the fact that both of us knew very well that it wouldn't be the last be restful. And I felt a shiver deep down in the pit of my stomach as I remember our last night together. Everything okay? Yes, yes, just an unpleasant news, but I'm okay. Okay, I'm sorry it's copping up night before an oral. No one wants to hear that kind of thing, but even is less so when it comes before a crucial moment. Try to sleep. Thanks for your empathy. I'm not totally devoid of it. You surprise me every day. You better off going to bed before I answer back. I'll follow the orders. I didn't feel like opening Nino's message again. Priya is right. I'll think about all this once the oral is over. I rehearsed a few key sentences for my oral and I finally fell asleep early. For the first time in the week, I got some very refreshing sleep. My alarm ran at 8 a.m. Even though my oral isn't scheduled until this afternoon, in any case, I've been awake since 7, too wound up to take advantage of the chance to sleep late. So, I'm going. What, already? I'm scheduled at 10, but it's only 8 p.m. and we are right nearby. You never know. If ever anything is blocking my way, I will have time to react. Blocking your way on foot between the dorms and the art building? Why, you're getting me mixed up. Go on, I was doing it to get to relax you. I'm sure you're going to ace it. See you later. Thanks. I tried to keep busy, carefully choosing my outfit for the oral and setting up my desk. Throughout the morning, I got feedback from the others as they came out of their orals. I'm done, and I'm relieved. You will see if it feels so good. See you Friday. Alexi did his, and Rosalie notifies us when she got out of her oral too. She felt like it went well, but she said she couldn't get things into perspective with all the accumulated stress. I waited my turn patiently in my room. No way I would eat anything whatsoever. My stomach is a knot, and I want to feel light during my oral. I'm starting to go crazy, going around in circles like a case lion. Whatever, I'm going earlier than planned. At least I will have some other than the wallpaper in my room to look at. I need to get some fresh air. So it looks like there is no one else waiting. It's really strange to be here all alone. I scanned all the shelves looking at what was the showcase. I ended up sitting down in a chair, tapping my nails on my notebook. Nervous? What are you doing here? What a warm welcome. Well, I mean, I wasn't expecting to see you here. Well, guess what? I'm doing the same thing as you. You are doing your oral here? Everyone is split up in different buildings, and it's kind of random as far as I can go. As far as I can tell. I'm scheduled for 4 p.m. in the main auditorium. And I'm in the smaller auditorium at 4.05 p.m. I pinch my skin between my thumb and my pointy finger, trying to massage it. What are you doing? I'm trying to use one of the anti-stress techniques I've learned recently. Not bad. I haven't heard of that one. I have different ones to manage stress before going on stage, if you are interested. Let's hear it. You sit down on a chair like this. Guess you'll spread his legs wide apart, slump back in the chair, and stick a disdainful, cocky pose. He looked a little as the school belonged to him, as if he was king of the world. That was what I thought to myself when I saw him do it. I couldn't keep from letting out a loud laugh. What game are you playing? Well, usually I do that when I'm alone. He straightened up embarrassed. To say that way you see yourself impact your attitude, for example. Someone really full of himself or self-confident isn't going to have the same body language as someone who is withdrawn or an introvert. And a social behavior specialist is the one who realizes that the opposite is also true. I'm not sure I understand. And basically, your body language can also impact your behavior. If you strike a pose, acting proud of yourself, or overplaying your confidence, I will eventually rip off on your mindset. Don't laugh. It's really been proven that it lowers your body level of cortisol. You know the stress hormone. You want me to try just so I will make a fool of myself. No, I swear I was giving you real advice. I already expected to go down. But I didn't know for sure until I tried. We heard the noise of a door opening and a female student came out of the main auditorium fast and crossed the lobby. The door closed behind her. We stood up on our chairs, clearing our throats. In any case, avoid using the technique in front of the jury. You're supposed to do it before an interview or before going in front of an audience. Thanks, get him obvious. Better safe than sorry. Betty, it's your turn. I started up right away. I straightened it up right away, picked up my fins, and smoothed out my outfit in a few moves. Catch up with you afterwards. You're going to ace it. Right. The auditorium definitely seems 10 times more impressive when standing alone facing a jury of 3. Good afternoon. Sit down and make yourself comfortable. You have everything you need behind you to look up your laptop up to the screen. I thanked the jury, setting my fins down on a chair. What the? All 3 of them looked up at me, and I pretended I wasn't flustered, fumbling around to look my computer up some way or another. Wait, let me help you. The connection is a little tricky. He stood up and came to help me to get everything set up. Why is he here? Was that planned? I wasn't expecting it. Actually, this could possibly work out in my favor. It's always like my work. There you are. You are set to go. Before getting started, I'd like to specify that there are above all the opportunities to share between the professors in the field. I'm professor at the Affiliated University of the other side of the country, and my sidekick is a gallery director in Utah. And obviously your thesis director is here as an observer. They won't judge your performance, but after your presentation, we may ask him some questions about the courses here you take this year for your major. Okay, I understand. The female professor speaking to me seems fairly kindly, and she is giving me an encouraging smile that has the advantage of making me feel comfortable. I breathe slowly through my nose, counting to 3, and then I started. Yes, it's over. I did it. I'm done. The student who seems younger than me giggled as he walked by me. Congrats. Sorry, I had to let it out. Looks like it went well from what I can see. I don't know, I think so. I said everything I intend to in any case. Let the chips fall where they may. What about you? I think so. Hey, are you coming to Yun's party Friday? I hear about it, yeah. I don't know yet. I will have to wait and see. Okay, try to come. It's going to be fun. Anyway, I have to run. I have something to do for a friend. Okay, see you later then. I said goodbye before heading downtown. I got this idea this morning, and I really wanted to do it. Chani doesn't show it, but I know she's stressed out by our oral, too. Lately, we had less time to get together because all our intense studying. Our oral is scheduled for 6 p.m., and I spotted a music shop in town that sells little stones. I did some research to find the stone that would help her for our oral. Sorry. I'd like to give it to her before she does her presentation. Shani has always been there for me. I frequently forget to ask her how she's doing, seeing as how she's always seems to be doing fine. But I know she is a perfectionist, otherwise she wouldn't have started writing several dissertations right from the start of the school year. Succeeding is a big deal for her. I walked into the little shop. There's a strong smell of incense in here, and things lying around absolutely everywhere. Ja, as the saleswoman for advice, she was an adorable old woman who smelled strongly of patchouli and had hundreds of bases on her wrist. She convinced that the stones I wanted to definitely be useful for Chinese oil and that it was a very good idea. So I picked a little aquamarine stone in pale blue and sparkling. Pay 15 gold. I thanked the saleswoman and crossed the street in a run. I wanted to catch Chani before she goes into the auditorium. I went to the gates and practically bumped into a group of girls. She must still be in the lobby waiting. I first have to go to the lobby. I caught my breath as I entered the lobby. The guy seems to be waiting his turn, but no sign of Chani. I looked at the time. Her turn is in 20 minutes. Strange, I hope she hasn't run into a problem. I sent a text to the group chat that everyone is in. I announced that I finished my turn and asked Chani where she was, but no answer. Now I can go here. Betty, is everything okay? I'm huffing and puffing. I'm having a hard time catching my breath. Yes, aren't you at your oral? It isn't until 6:35 p.m. I was about to leave. Oh, I thought it was at 6 p.m. I must have misread it. The time in our chat. Is everything okay? Did you want to get together? Come on in. I have something for you. I pulled the little red bag tied with the sick ribbon out of my pocket. What is it? A present. For me? Open it. Okay. She took a little blue stone out of the bag and studied it closely in the palm of her hands. It's an aquamarine. Hey, you recognized it. It's for my oral exam, thanks. She threw herself into my arms and gave me a kiss on the cheek. Why am I getting a present? I don't know what to say. You've always been there for me. All year, and all I wanted to know you wanted to show you some support. I'm really tough. I'm going to keep it with me. Thanks. I have to go. It will be better if I'm early. Stay focused and keep the little stone with you. I didn't think I had ripped off at you such an extent. And don't forget, we are meeting up at 10 p.m. at the Cosy Beer Café. You can count on me. We went out, then I headed towards my room to get ready for the party. I called my parents as soon as I had walked through the door of my room. They are stuck in traffic on the highway and will get into town later, so they will meet me straight at the coffee beer. I need to hurry and find an outfit to meet up with you, to help him get everything ready. I felt so relieved to have finished the oral. I'm as excited as can be about tonight. I wrote Emma again, but she still hasn't given me a sign of life. I don't even know if she is aware of what happened. Maybe she has managed to stay focused on her oral tool and switched off her phone. I'll try later again. I did a quick mental introspection of my closet. I still can make up my mind between three outfits. Okay, this is the one for Ryan. This is the one for Hyun and Priya. And this is the one for Nathaniel and Cashew. This very sophisticated low-neck dress that I've never wear. Tonight is my chance. This will be perfect for tonight. This time to meet up with Hyun at the cafe. Hey, where are you going like that? I'm going to help you with the party. Are you coming later? Of course, we couldn't miss it for the world. Alexei took me in his arms. We passed our oral presentation. Can you believe it? It's over. I have trouble believing it. Yeah. Did your orals go well, Morgan? Yes, I think things went well. I went towards him and he was perfect as usual. But yeah, the end of the year is approaching. Yeah, it's gone by fast. Do I need to cling to you like a mussel on a rock? What? Are you going to disappear at the graduation? Morgan, hold on to her. If you hold on to me like that, yeah, I'm going to do it everything I can to escape as quickly as possible from the city. Are you going to chase her away? Sorry, stay, I won't do it again. It's a deal. Yes. Come on, we won't hold you up any longer. Go. Okay, Yoon, it's all alone. His best is oral this morning at 10 o'clock. I absolutely have to go help him out. We'll come as soon as we are ready. That VA we can help out too. Thanks, that's nice of you. Since I finished my oral presentation, the university has felt like a summer camp. I feel much more relaxed. Before, I would have said that it felt like the end of the year, but for me, it's actually the end of my studies. Hey, you are already here. I thought you would come later. Well, I wanted to help you out, but I looked around the table where I sat. All the glasses were out and he was spreading out the making of the appetizers. But it looks like you didn't have needed me in the end. Did your oral presentation go well? I don't know. I hope so. We won't have to wait for the results for long. Maybe a week and a half. Yeah, so is everyone coming tonight? Yes, I told everyone to bring whoever they wanted. So there may be more people than planned, but hey, is all this alright with Clemens? Well, yes, as long as things don't go overboard during the party. It should be okay. I will be careful. Will your parents be here soon? Later in the evening. Give me something to do. I'm your assistant. I'm here to help you. Okay, if you insist, you can ice the cupcakes. Oh my. If you tell me how to do it step by step, I should be able to manage. Don't worry, it's a piece of cake. We cook until the sunset. And we also heard from less people who took their orals. Apparently, it's a huge release for everyone. Voila, I finished preparing the appetizers, the cupcakes, the punch, and the alcohol-free cocktail. I think that is it. Maybe I could make extra crepes. Are you kidding? There's enough to feed an army. I know. You never know. I'd rather not be short of anything. Right, but now we already have 3 trays of pastries, 2 cakes, 9 plates of appetizers, rice salad, and tabbouleh. Obviously, if you list them all at once, it sounds strange. You are really passionate about food, not to say obsessed. It's what I really like about you, actually, Yoon. Even though I'm not on your route right now. When I invite people, I like doing things right. What's more, where do you get all these? Are you fooding by Bill? Clemens tipped in. She was willing to supply the ingredients. But obviously we'll charge people for the dessert and appetizers. Already let everyone know about that. The party is starting pretty late. They may have already eaten by then. Too bad, we'll have out the leftovers. What can I do for me? For me, food is sacred. It's to your credit, but we could try to stay reasonable. Reasonable? At the graduation party? Dream on. Ha, you don't even know what we are talking about. No, but I'm sure I'm right. Come on in. Come in. Lexi, Morgan, Rosalie and Leek walked through the door with arms full of shopping bags. We bought chips and drinks too. Rosalie ice chopped short of the buffet. Maybe we actually should have held back. You went berserk. Yep. This hardly surprised me about my favorite roommate. I'm your only roommate. This makes you my favorite. What about me? What am I then? A nice squatter. My favorite squatter. We finalized the last little details and people trickled in. In the end, Hume was right to prepare so much. There's a much bigger crowd than planned. Everyone brought extra guests along. It dawned on me that the Hume and I may not have planned on cleaning and straightening up after such a big party. But hey, Hume told me not to think about it and to enjoy it in the meantime. I did my best to follow his advice. Hi, yes, she managed to come. How are you? I threw myself into her arms, kissing her on the cheek. I thought about making the hug last, but I figured my parents might walk through the door any second now. And I think I'd rather talk to them beforehand instead of them seeing me with Priya that way without having met her. Is everything okay? Are they here yet? No, not yet. Okay, remember, I support you, no matter what you decide. You don't have to introduce me right away if you don't want to. I want you to be comfortable with it. Essie, I haven't had time to give it any thought. I'll see when time comes. Go get yourself a drink, grab a muffin and relax. Okay, I'm going to try. By the way, no news about, you know, Nina? Yes, she's texted me, but she doesn't know anything more about it than us. And Amber hasn't answered me. Same goes for me. We will definitely find out more in the next few days. I know you're worried, but try not to think about it too much. Tonight either. Enjoy yourself. Yeah, right, I'm going to try. And Yuna prepared a perfect party playlist, and everyone was tapping their feet to the beat of the music from the two dancers. It brings back memories for all of us and really fires up the atmosphere. There are people outside talking. I'm going to have a look. Oh, hey. Hey, great party. It's cool that you could come. I didn't know you knew Hyun. No, it was Cassie. We ran into one another in the street and he invited me. I had nothing planned tonight, so yeah. Cassie was here? Yeah, he's around here somewhere. Being the star that he is, I think he was approached by a groupie, I think. A groupie? I looked around for him, but he must be inside. Any news from Nathaniel? Since he has been back, he's just disappeared again, right? I heard something about the police, but still no news from Nathaniel. The guy is a real snail. As soon as someone gets close to him, he takes revenge in a new shell with green hair. I never thought about it like that, but that does suit him. Keep me posted, I promise. I've seen some cheese croissants over there. They are calling my name. See you later. Okay. I was about to go in to try and see some more familiar faces, but at that moment, Kesho came out, accompanied by... In any case, I'm really a huge fan of the last excerpt. Did you write the song too, or... Actually, it was a collaboration with Cabin. I didn't know what Cabin wrote songs. I don't think he knew either. Yelene burst out laughing while touching Kesho's forearm for half a second. I hate to have to choose something now, because if you choose A, it goes down with Kesho, and if you choose B, it goes down with Yelene. So, nothing you choose goes up anyway. I'm better go for B. I need to get Kesho a little bit higher, so... Of hold him a little bit higher, so I'm gonna go that way. Who is Cabin? The bassist of the group. Okay, oh right, of course. Is there a problem, Melody? No, not at all. Do you know each other? Since it created Cornstorm, I was always seeing her at concerts. But last time we actually spoke to one another was during your little dispute at the gym, I think. Yelene and I looked at one another, a bit embarrassed. Yes, we remember that well. I think that things have evolved since then. I hope so too. Oh, I think that... congratulations, my darling daughter. Mom. Congratulations, they held me tightly in their arms. I felt strangely emotional being reunited with them after the end of my exams. It's a relief, and a feeling of security took over me. No matter what happens, they will always be here to support me after events. Are you alright? You are shaking. I'm just happy to see you. So are we. My dad took out an enormous bouquet of flowers from behind his back. Congratulations. Thank you, they are beautiful, but I don't even know if I passed my exams or... In any case, we made it to the end, and that deserves at least flowers, and that we be here for you. Thank you, and happy you are here. I realized that the party around us had slowed a bit, as people were still partying, particularly watching us at the same time. Oh, Yelene, how are you? Very good, thank you. And you? We are good. Happy to be here after getting through that horrible traffic. It's definitely vacation time. Sibyl isn't here. No, I mean she may be here for the graduation ceremony, but not before then. Okay, don't hesitate to say hi to her for us. I will. Well, are you going to introduce us to everyone, dear? Yes. This is Kesho, who... I recognize you. You were at Sweetie Morris with Melody, right? Yes. We went to high school together. Are you in a rock group now? Crack and Rum or Coco Steam? I can't remember the name, but I've seen the clip on TV. And you were in the group. It's Crownstorm, Mom. Oh yes, sorry. Oh gosh, congratulations for your career. Thank you, yes, it's pretty great. Do you want something to drink? Great idea, we are dying of thirst. I turned towards kissing in the Yelene before following my parents. See you two later. Yes. The party is full swing. It looks like he invited everyone from his program. There are more and more people who I don't know. The mood is nice and relaxed. Some of the guests are even dancing on the improvised dance floor. Come on, we can get something from the bar. We managed to make our way as best as possible to the bar. Farther away, I saw Priya talking with a young man. She doesn't see us. She practically had her back towards us. I was having a hard time keeping them close to me. They seemed to be observing the student attentively. I don't know them all. Finally, the party has a bit. What did you say? Wait, come with me. We will be able to hear each other better at the bar. And, is everything going as you like? Yes, actually, I got a message from Clemens asking if everyone was going all well. Do you think she will come? Where are you doing something wrong? Well, let's just say that she thinks there are dozens of us here. But there are at least 50 people here. I know, I got carried away. I invite everyone I know, near and far. I was in a good mood. Gosh, that brings back memories. I'd like you to meet my parents. Oh yes, Billy told me you were coming. I'm pleased to meet you. I apologize for making you wait through this conversation. I didn't know that. Come on, you are going to offend us. We were young ones too. We all went overboard at one time or another. I will be here to clean up with you tomorrow, don't worry. Yes, in any case, I locked all the cabinets and the proposition that belonged to the cafe that we shouldn't touch. I'm sure everything will go well. Betty, I was looking for you. Can I talk to you? Amber, but did you get my... Please, can I talk to you? It's urgent. I looked towards Ryun and my parents. Don't worry, go ahead. Come with me. I will serve you a drink. Thank you. I'll be right back. I'm sorry. I felt that the moment of introducing Priya to my parents would come before that I did go to Amber with Amber in the kitchen. But maybe it comes afterwards. I didn't saw this part, but this is what I expected. Don't worry, we won't be far. Okay, thanks. Let's go to the kitchen. We passed behind the bar to get to the kitchen. What did you want to? I got you, Mrs. I'm sorry I didn't answer right away. But I went directly there and I want to see the police. I know more. Then I had to pass my oral presentation this morning and... Oh, did your presentation go well? And how do you know if Nathaniel is alright? You can ask him yourself. You have his number? You can contact him? Hey... Oh my gosh, I couldn't help put my hand on his shoulder to check if he was really alive in front of us. What happened? I thought that they were arrested and... Yes, they are all arrested. No one of them is free. And what will happen now? Justice will do his duty, but seeing the main charges brought against them, they surely will go all to prison. Before being associated with the police, I had collected as much proof as possible against them. And that will all be taken into account in the trial. And you? I will also be brought to trial. But by collaborating with the police and helping to take down the network, my sentence would be lighter. But still a sentence. I don't know anything else right now. We will have to wait. That means that everything isn't over yet. Yes, everything is over. It's over for me. I've gotten out. Ned took a step towards us both. He took Amber's hand and mine. And I would never have done it without you. You opened my eyes. Thank you both of you for standing up to me. And when it was necessary. He took us both in his arms. I still think that it is because I don't am on his route. And I'm not wearing the right outfit. You did it. You finally got into one of those silly detective novels that you read since you were little. Hey, they aren't silly. So do you plan on leaving your hair like this? Like that for long? Ah, thank you. Wait, I like it. I laughed a bit before realizing that my parents are waiting for me. Oh, I have to go. My parents are here. I abandoned them when I came to get my to when you came to get me, Amber. I thought I recognized them, but I wasn't sure of myself. Sorry, I have to go, but enjoy the evening and have fun. I think I'm going to go home and take a nice shower and sleep for a week, but you have fun. I'm going to leave discreetly. No one recognized you? I guess my looks get the job done. Amber took me in her arms to say goodbye, and they both walk out the door. I regained my composure after this waste of information. I have to join my parents. I looked for them for a while before realizing they were at the dance floor dancing their adults. They are pretty cute. Maybe I will let them finish this song before begging them to never break out of the movements again. They looked like straight out of a Saturday Night Fever. I found my comment pretty funny. Actually, it would surely make my mom laugh too. Is everything going as you want it? Yes. Am I dreaming, or was that Amber accompanied by her brother earlier? I thought I saw them leaving the bar. No, you weren't dreaming. They came to tell me that it was over. The whole traffic network was stopped. Seriously? Yes, and I quickly will pry up what happened in the kitchen earlier. Well, we will just have to wait and see how the trial turns out. Yes. Who are you watching on the dance floor like that? My parents. Oh. Actually, do you want to come? I will introduce you. What? I reached out my hand towards her. I'm tired of hearing the word boyfriend all the time. It's time that I introduce you, and I feel ready to do so. You make me happy, Priya, and I want you to complete an entire part of my life. Great idea to make me cry right before I meet your parents. She hit her teary eyes and nodded her head to say yes. Later today, we walked across the cafe to meet him. My parents ended their dances to the last song by laughing and falling into one another's arms. It's so touching to see them definitely crazy in love of one another, still today. It's like you are having a great good time. We haven't done that in years, but your father hasn't lost any of his mojo. Same for you. You still have all your charms. My dad kissed my mother timidly on the cheek. I'd like you to meet Priya. We were at Sweet Amores together and we found one another here at the university. It's a pleasure to meet you. Your face did look familiar. I do seem to remember you. Yes, I arrived in the middle of the year. It's nice to meet you, Priya. Are you studying art history with Melody? No, I'm studying law and I will pass the bar exam in a few months. A future lawyer? That's quite a profession. Yes, I've wanted to do it for a long time now, and I finally reached my goal. Mom, I took a big breath while thinking that this looked much easier to do from the other side of the cafe when I was watching them dance. I slide my hand into Priya's. This is also why I wanted to introduce you to Priya. She is more than a friend. I look towards Priya, who is as red as a tomato and who is squeezing my hand tightly. Oh, I see. We found one another at the university, and we've been together for a few months now. Dad looked at our hands. Mom was watching Dad, and no one said a word. This moment only lasted for a half a second, but I felt like my heart was going to explode. We are very happy to meet you, Priya. Yes, very happy. I am happy to meet you as well. Betty, you could have corrected me when I used the term boyfriend. I didn't know how you would handle the news, and me, us, we only wish you happiness. The rest is your business. Even if I wasn't really worried about the reaction, I felt a weight being lifted from my stomach immediately. And so, Priya, do you know how to dance? They said that the lawyers are very serious, so I wouldn't want to put you in an awkward position. Is that a challenge? Priya, you really don't have to. Believe me, you will stay on the dance floor all night, and honestly, I will take it. As soon as those words came out of Priya's mouth, the next song started as if by magic. Oh my gosh, Lucia, did you hear that? end of the 90s get on feet from desire, that brings back memories. Paya posed like a disco star, but pointed her finger in the air and putting her other hand on her hip. Oh, awesome. And I couldn't help but burst out laughing and seeing my dad imitate her with a very serious look on his face. And you, instead of laughing, come show us if you inherit your parents' talent. My mother dragged me on the dance floor with her and tried as her best as I could to keep up despite that I couldn't stop laughing. We spent the evening laughing, and after having danced our hearts out to the music, we had a drink together. We talked until late into the night. I haven't had such a good night in a very long time. My heart is light as a feather, and everything is going perfectly. Finish the episode. So this was episode 18 with the Root of Praia. Thank you for watching. I hope to see you all in my next video. Maybe until then. Bye!